Throughout history, man has seen fit to rape, plunder, and pillage the Earth's natural resources. As toxic waste dumps pollute our soil and chemical vapors poison our air, the sea, the birthplace of life on our planet, is slowly succumbing to man's flagrant and criminally negligent attitude towards its preservation. While our oceans continue to be a major source for food and entertainment, beautiful and majestic sea creatures continue to be slaughtered while industrial waste decimates all life beneath the surface. Over time, commercial fishermen have all but ruined the local fishing economy. Overfishing has nearly depleted some species of once popular fish, while the use of nets and anchors have destroyed much of their natural habitat. But in all this bleakness, today, less than 100 meters off the Guanacaste beach of Playa, Hermosa, Costa Rica, a few of this area's residents are beginning to fight back and win. There was a famous line in the movie Field of Dreams that says, "If you build it, they will come." This phrase has become the cornerstone to Playa Hermosa's new and aggressive plan to save our precious natural surroundings. Professional scuba diver and longtime Playa Hermosa resident Christian Lamouche decided enough was enough. If the local sea life had any chance to survive, a new habitat needed to be built and human behaviors needed to change. So Christian, along with other local divers, set out to create new habitat by building durable and environmentally safe artificial reefs. Not satisfied dumping old toxic construction materials, used tires, junked automobiles, or sinking old boats into the bay, Christian's vision for a new reef network was rooted more in the environment. By using new cinder blocks and arranging them into igloo-shaped communities, these new fish condominiums would form the basis of a completely new undersea habitat designed to rejuvenate life beneath Bahia Hermosa. Thus became the genesis for Condofish. Now, following nearly 1 year since the first igloo was deployed, local divers and fishermen report that the fish are returning to Playa Hermosa. Condofish is working as intended, providing the habitat necessary to create and maintain life. Condofish Phase 1 conclusively proved that concept. However, it also showed there was room for improvement. The second phase of this project will remedy those shortcomings discovered in Phase 1. Phase 2 will utilize a pre-manufactured solid steel skeletal frame on which the concrete cinder blocks will be set. This frame will create an elevated foundation, making the entire structure less susceptible to ocean currents and fluctuation of the bay's sandy bottom. In addition, a new steel dome will top off the igloo and also provide the basis on which high-volume oyster farming can take place. The other major enhancement in Phase 2 solves the logistical issue of deployment. Phase 1 required that all materials be taken by boat or barge to the construction site and lowered by hand to the bottom. This methodology was not just unreliable and time-consuming, but was becoming very costly. In addition, it was impossible to reposition the structure once it was in place. Phase 2 solves all of these issues. The steel frame and cinder blocks are delivered to the beach during a period of low tide. A newly designed ambient pressure underwater buoyant device, also known as the submarine, allows the divers to raise and lower the Condofish unit by either filling the tank with water or displacing the water with compressed air. This neutral buoyancy device makes it very easy for one or two divers to accurately position the unit in its desired location. In just a matter of minutes, all the bricks are placed into the steel frame, thereby creating the walls of the new igloo. Pod-like legs extend from beneath the frame to form the base on which the igloo sits, thus permitting tidal water to flow unencumbered. Once the unit is fully constructed, there's nothing to do but wait for Mother Nature to do her thing. Eventually, the tide comes in and allows the condofish to be moved. A careful combination of water and compressed air makes the new condofish easily maneuverable in the now waist-deep water. The divers are able to position the unit directly over its intended new home. Valves on the submarine are adjusted, allowing water to displace the air. The condofish gently sinks to the bottom. Fine-tuning the final destination of the unit is accomplished by introducing air into the tank. This will give it just enough buoyancy, thereby allowing the divers to position the unit in its exact location. Once in place, the tank is then disconnected from the igloo and floated to the surface. The steel rods are then delivered by small boat and then lowered to the divers below. The divers weave the rods across the top, securing them with wire, creating the unit's new dome. Well, there's nothing to do now except wait. In time, algae, barnacles, and thousands of other minute sea creatures will affix themselves to the new cinder blocks and steel rods. Life, as nature originally intended, will take over and hopefully flourish. Efforts like condofish are the only real solution to undo and erase the man-made havoc which we're creating. But all of this will be in vain if we don't stop and change our destructive ways. Man is killing this planet, and only man can save it. We hope you've enjoyed this video and have found the information informative and helpful. Our only request of you is this. Next time you're at the beach and you see some garbage laying around, pick it up and throw it in the nearest garbage can. Help do your part to keep the beaches of the world clean.